Welcome to Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video find function in Excel, watch the video till the end. And if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone. Today we are going to study a concept that is find function in Excel. Let's begin. Well, before we start working on this, we need to understand the find function in Excel is used to find the location of the character, or basically subtracting in a text or a string. Well, the find function, if we just start, we'll just type find and it will show us find text within text and start number. In this scenario, how will you do things? See, the find formula in Excel is like, you know, it shows find text, which is the text that you want to find. Within text, what do you want to find? It is basically the text string to search within. And the start number is basically the optional. It specifies from which character the search begins, and the default is 1. The find function in Excel searches for the find text and in within the text and returns the position of the first concurrence of the find text and is within the text. So the find text can be a character or a substring, and it can be both the find text or within the text. If the find function in Excel is, let's say, not able, I'd say, if the find function X is not able to find the text character is within the text, it gives the value error, and the Excel find function is basically case sensitive and does not support the wildcard, asterisks, question marks, and types. So if you want use search to be the case sensitive or including the wildcards, you may use a search function in Excel. Well, how does this thing work? You use uses of what we call as a find function in Excel. How does this work? Well, the find function in Excel is used widely for different purposes, mostly in association with other Excel function, and the Excel find function can be used. Now, it is used to extract the number of times a substring or a string basically combines and appears in a range. Second, the find function is used to basically extract the words occurring after a specific character. Now, find function Excel is used to extract the URL, and it is used to get the first or the last name. So it is used to find the occurrence of the substring, and find function Excel is used to remove any unwanted texts. Okay, now how to use the find function Excel? See, the Excel find function is very simple and easy to use. Let's understand the working of the find function. Well, with example number one, that's what we are going to start with. Suppose you want to find the location of leopard A in leopard. Okay, how are you going to do? So if leopard is given in A3 over here, A is given in B3 as shown above. The formula for find in Excel will be something like this, is equal to find what? Text B3, this one, and you want to find within the text this one, you'll say it's the fifth. So find in Excel will return 5 as it occurs at fifth position in the leopard. Well, instead of the cell references, you may directly enter the character as shown now in the following formula for find in Excel. You will say is equal to find in that A, close a bracket, and you will write leopard as the answer and close the bracket, so it will again show us 5. So that's the another way of doing it. So the find function Excel can be used to find the number of the cells which a substring is occurring in the range of the cells. Let us see an example of this functionality. How does things work here? Example number 2, suppose you have a list of the text string in A3 to A6 as shown here. Now in this list, you want to identify the number of the items the character I is occurring in the list over here. So you may use the formula for find in Excel to identify this is something like this. So it will be is equal to sum product. Okay. In that, you'll use the 2 hyphen. Then you'll use is number in that. And in is number, you will find again. Find what? I and comma. Within the text, A3 to A6, 1, 2, 3, 4, close the bracket. Okay. So, in the above formula for the find, what we were supposed to find, I. So, it will say 3. And just press Control D, so over here, 2. So, what you can do, just make this constant. Now it will give us some of the other way of correct answer. how things should go. Well, this is how the formula works here. We'll see example number 3. In the example number 3, suppose you have a list of the names as shown here, Priyanka, Divyanka, and so on and so forth. Well, in this list, you want to find the number of the names in which Ansh or Anka occurs. So you can do so using the following formula to find in Excel. You will use is equal to sum product. Okay, sum product, open the bracket, in that, press this double sign. You can use is number here. Okay, in that, use the find function. Say Ansh, okay, or you can say Anka, that's what you want to use. Okay, so Ansh, once you have find that, you can actually copy the whole formula. Let me do that for you. So this is how the formula will look like. Sum product is number. You need to find what Ansh from A3 to A10, right, within that number, is number, find Anka from the below list of A3 to A10, and it should be greater than 0. So once you have this formula set properly, well, in that scenario, your work gets really very easy. And how does the formatting will work? Well, the answer, the formula to find in an Excel will be the one that is shown here. So it will give you the correct answer as the fourth number as it is shown here. Well, after this, I want you to remember some of the things. See, the find function returns the position of the first occurrence, okay, of the find texts, and in within text, okay. That's the first thing. These are the things you should remember. Second, the find function is basically, if you see, it is a case sensitive, okay, and it does not allow the so-called wildcard characters. Now, in the find text, an empty string, okay, what you do is you just write the find function will return as 1. Fourth, the Excel find function cannot find text within text, so it gives a basically a value error. And the last one is that, you know, if the start number is, let's say, 0, negative or greater than within the text, the find function returns to the thing called as value error. I hope you have got a fantastic idea how exactly this particular topic works, how the find function works. So if you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, then please like, comment on this video, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you, everyone.